sa ng tao. Sa takdang panahon ay inawag mo isang bayang lingkod sa iyo. Halina Jesus, halina, halina Jesus, halina. Halina Jesus, halina, halina Jesus, halina. Halina Jesus, halina, halina Jesus, halina.
Maraming salamat po. Please turn your mobile phones to silent mode as we begin the celebration of the Holy Mass. Please all stand and let us sing the entrance hymn.
Ang haring malwalati ay darating na, puso'y buksan, awitan siyang maligaya. Sino ang haring ala niya'y ano nga ba? Siya'y ang Emmanuel, pangako nung una. Ang haring malwalati ay darating na, puso'y buksan, awitan siyang maligaya.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Good afternoon, brothers and sisters.
Good afternoon po, Padre.
Welcome to the parish and national shrine of Saint Padre Pio, and welcome to our sixth day of Simbang Gabi, our nine-day preparation for the solemnity of the birth of our Savior, Lord Jesus Christ. Together with all our intentions, we pray for all those people who recommend themselves to our prayers, those who are celebrating their birthdays and anniversaries today, those who continuously trusting themselves to the prayers of Mama Mary and Padre Pio for their sickness and their petitions, and for the eternal repose of all our beloved loved ones. Let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess to Almighty God, and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done, in what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask the Blessed Mary, Ever Virgin, and all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy.
Let us pray. O God, who through the childbearing of the Holy Virgin graciously revealed the radiance of your glory to the world, grant, we pray, that we may venerate with integrity of faith the mystery of so wondrous an incarnation, and always celebrate it with due reverence. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. The Lord spoke to Ahaz, "Ask for a sign from the Lord your God. Let it be deep as the netherworld or high as the sky." But Ahaz answered, "I will not ask. I will not tempt the Lord." Then Isaiah said, "Listen, O house of David. Is it not enough for you to weary men? Must you also weary my God? Therefore, the Lord himself will give you this sign. The virgin shall conceive and bear a son, and shall name him Emmanuel." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Responsorial Psalm B. Let the Lord enter. He is the King of glory.
Let the Lord enter. He is the King of glory. The Lord's are the earth and its fullness, the world and those who dwell in it. For he founded it upon the seas and established it upon the rivers.
Let the Lord enter. He is the King of glory.
Who can ascend the mountain of the Lord? Or who may stand in his holy place? He whose hands are sinless, whose heart is clean, who desires not what is vain.
Let the Lord enter. He is the King of glory.
He shall receive a blessing from the Lord, a reward from God his Savior. Such is the race that seeks for him, that seeks the face of the God of Jacob.
Let the Lord enter. He is the King of glory. Please all stand.
Alleluia. Of God, eternal kingdom. Come and free the prisoners of darkness. Alleluia. Alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Saint Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
In the sixth month, the angel Gabriel was sent from God to a town of Galilee called Nazareth, to a virgin betrothed to a man named Joseph of the house of David, and the virgin's name was Mary. And coming to her, he said, "Hail, full of grace, the Lord is with you." But she was greatly troubled at what was said, and pondered what sort of greeting this might be. Then the angel said to her, "Do not be afraid, Mary, for you have found favor with God. Behold, you will conceive in your womb and bear a son, and you shall name him Jesus. He will be great and will be called Son of the Most High. And the Lord God will give him the throne of David his father. And he will rule over the house of Jacob forever. And of his kingdom there will be no end. But Mary said to the angel, How can this be, since I have no relations with a man? And the angel said to her in reply, The Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. Therefore the child to be born will be called Holy, the Son of God. And behold, Elizabeth, your relative, has also conceived a son in her old age, and this is the sixth month for her who was called barren, for nothing will be impossible with God. Mary said, Behold, I am the handmaid of the Lord. May it be done to me according to your word. Then the angel departed from her. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Muli po, magandang hapon sa inyong mga naririto sa atin sa pambansang Dambana, gayon din sa mga patuloy na nakikisa sa atin via live streaming, especially those who are joining us abroad via our Facebook page. Ano pong kalakip at kasama ng inyong pagbibigay ng sarili sa Diyos? In our Gospel of today, we heard Mary giving her yes to the Lord. Si Maria ay nagbigay ng kanyang pag-oo sa Diyos, nagbigay ng kanyang pagsang-ayon. When Mary gave her yes to the Lord, it is the same way of giving her whole self to the Lord. Ang pagbibigay ni Maria ng sarili sa Diyos, ng kanyang oo, ay katumbas ng kanyang pagbibigay ng buong buhay sa Diyos. Ano pong kaya ninyong ibigay para sa pagsunod sa Diyos? Tayo po ay nasa ika-anim ng simbang gabi. Palapit na tayo sa Pasko ng pagsilang ng Panginoon. Ano nang nagawa ng mga simbang gabing ito sa atin? Tayo ba ay mas lumapit kay Kristo? Tayo ba ay naging mas mapagmahal tulad niya? At tayo ba ay nakatulad kay Maria that when she gave her yes, she gave her whole self, not only of those happy moments and experiences, but also those bitter and problematic experiences of her life. Nang nagbigay si Maria ng oo, package deal, hindi lamang kapag masaya, kundi din pati sa kalungkutan, nananatiling oo ang pagtugon ni Maria sa kalooban ng Diyos. Mga minamahal, napakadali pong tumugon sa Diyos kapag ka masaya ang nangyayari sa buhay. Napakasarap pong magdasal, napakasarap manalangin kapag ka walang problema. Parang napakalapit natin sa Diyos kapag ka wala tayong iniisip. Paano po kapag ka may sakit? Paano po pagka maraming utang? Paano pagka marami kayong pinagkakaabalahan? Marami kayong alalahanin? Paano tayo nakakatugon sa Diyos? Tumulad tayo kay Maria. Nung nagbigay ng oo, hindi lamang sa masayang pagkakataon, kundi pati sa mga pagsubok ay naka-oo siya pagdating sa kalooban ng Diyos. Tatlong bagay sa pag-oo ni Maria. Ang pag-oo ni Maria ay pag-oong sumusunod, pag-oong nagtitiwala, at pag-oong nagmamahal. The yes of Mary when she gave it to the Lord following the will of God is a yes that is obedient, a yes that is trustful, and a yes that is loving. And we are being invited in our everyday life that we might like Mary. Kapag dumadating po ang pagkakataong hindi nyo alam ang gagawin, dapat patuloy pa rin nagtitiwala sa Diyos. Kapag ka dumadating ang pagkakataong nagkakaroon ng problema, dapat patuloy na sumusunod sa Diyos. At sa lahat ng pagkakataon, kahit na sa mga pagkakataong parang hindi natin siya maramdaman, dapat tayo ay nagmamahal sa Diyos. That is the yes of Mary. And we are being encouraged today on our sixth day of Simbang Gabi to give also our yes to God. Bilang mga magulang, bilang mga anak, bilang mga kaibigan, we should always give our yes to God every day. Sapagkat wala pong pinakamahalaga kundi ang pagsunod sa kalooban ng Diyos. Oo, at minsan ay parang mahirap unawain. Oo, at minsan ay parang mahirap tanggapin. Pero may paraan ang Diyos upang ipaunawa sa atin na ang kanyang kalooban ang pinakamahalaga. Ngayong Paskong darating, kaninong kalooban ang inyong pamamayanihin sa inyong sarili? Mamamayani ba ang iyong kaloobang madamot? Mamamalagi ba ang iyong kaloobang mataray? Mananatili ba ang iyong kaloobang magagalitin? O pananatilihin mo ang kalooban ng Diyos, yung kaloobang nagmamahal sa lahat ng pagkakataon? Let us be reminded of our Aral Batanggenyo, our local catechism here in Batangas. Number 181, ang sabi po doon, si Maria ay may kabahagi sa pagliligtas ni Kristo. Yun ay sa kanyang pagsang-ayon sa plano ng Diyos. When Mary gave her yes to God, it is her participation to the salvation history and story of Jesus saving all mankind. Ang ating pagsunod sa kalooban ng Diyos, kahit minsan ay mahirap, kahit minsan ay malabo, kahit minsan ay nakakapagod, ay ang ating pakikibahagi sa gawang pagliligtas ni Kristo. Ano pong kalooban ng Diyos sa inyo ngayon? Kalooban ng Diyos na ikay maging magulang. At kung ito'y kalooban ng Diyos, maging mabuti kang magulang. Kalooban ng Diyos na ikay maging anak, maging kaibigan. Kung ito'y kanyang kalooban, ikay dapat maging mabuting kaibigan, mabuting anak. Kalooban ng Diyos na minsan tayo ay magdusa upang mas lalo tayong lumapit sa Kanya. Nawa po sa mga pagkakataong ito, mas lumalim sa atin na mamutawi at mamayani ang kalooban ng Diyos. Yung tulad ni Maria, yung kanyang pag-oo ay maitulad natin sa Kanya. Yung pag-oo na sumusunod, pag-oo na nagtitiwala, at pag-oo na nagmamahal. Let us ask Jesus, when we receive Him later in the communion, ibulong niyo po sa Kanya, Panginoon, bigyan mo po ako ng isang sumusunod, nagtitiwala, at nagmamahal na puso, upang sa aking pang-araw-araw na buhay, at sa aking paghahanda sa iyong pagdating ngayong Pasko, ako'y manatiling laging nakatuon sa aking pagsunod, pagtitiwala, at pagmamahal sa iyong kalooban.
Please all stand.
Brethren, the response of the Blessed Virgin Mary of her yes to God's plan will be the fulfillment of our salvation. Come and let us continue to see the sign of God's blessing on His people. Let us together say, Lord, hear us.
Lord, hear us.
For the Catholic Church, so that with the guidance of the Holy Spirit, the people may be led to the path and teachings of Christ. Let us pray.
Lord, hear us.
For the nations, so that the signs of God's protection may exist in the lives of the citizens whose promotion is the development of peace and governance, let us pray.
Lord, hear us.
For those who are in the lost state due to injustice or illness, and those who are in prison, so that God's eternal favor may reach them, let us pray.
Lord, hear us.
For our family that makes up our parish and community, so that we can be open to being God's tool in caring for our neighbor, let us pray.
Lord, hear us.
God our Father, protect and fill our hearts with joy and hope so that we can look forward to the blessings brought by the coming Messiah, through him our Lord, forever and ever.
Amen. For your offerings in the envelope, you may drop them at the collection baskets. Please all stand.
Pray, brethren, that my sacrifice and yours may be for good and may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hand for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Look, O Lord, we pray, upon the one sacrifice of your Son, that by participating in the mystery, we may possess at last the gifts we have awaited and for which our faith bids us hope, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For all the oracles of the prophets foretold him, the Virgin Mother longed for him with love beyond all telling. John the Baptist sang of his coming and proclaimed his presence when he came. It is by his gift that already we rejoice at the mystery of his nativity, so that he may find us watchful in prayer and exultant in his praise. And so with the angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory as without end we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
Those those who are unable to kneel, please remain standing with reverence.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise, for through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy, and you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, up your sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, for they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. At his command, we celebrate these mysteries. For in the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
And we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of his saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward for his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you will to reconcile us by yourself. Grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, the Mother of God, with Saint Joseph, her most chaste spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, with Saint Padre Pio and with all the saints, on his constant intercession in your presence, we rely for unfailing help. May the sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis our Pope and Gilbert our Bishop, the order of bishops and all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family, whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our dead brothers and sisters, and to all who were pleasing to you, at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory. Through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, All glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Lord, we pray, from every evil, graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on your faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy. Take away the sins of the world. Grant us peace. Grant us peace.
Those who are unable to kneel, please remain standing with reverence.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
upang kami makasamba ng wakas at maligaya, wakas at maligaya. Lakasan ng inyong loob, tayo'y huwag matakot, dumarating ang buong Diyos upang tayo'y matubos at sa Kanya'y makadulog. Panginoon, parito ka sa amin ay ipadama kapayapaan mo't sigla upang kami makasamba ng wakas at maligaya, ng wakas at maligaya. Ating ngayong hinihintay si Jesus na pong mahal. Ang aban nating kalatawan ay Kanyang bibigyan na nga.
The second collection, which will be done, is for the continuing development of the parish and national shrine of St. Padre Pio. Thank you for your offering.
Panginoon, parito ka sa akin ay ipadama kapayapaan mo't sigla upang kami makasamba ng wakas at maligaya, ng wakas at maligaya.
Please all stand.
Let us pray. Grant divine protection, O Lord, to those you renew with this heavenly gift, that to those who delight in your mysteries, you may give the joy of true peace through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Prayer for intention to Santo Padre Pio. All together. Padre Pio, holy monk from Pietrelcina, outstanding saint of the present era, our bright beacon in this earthly pilgrimage, our sanctuary in times of trouble, holy exemplar of great courage, with you our needs do we confide, as well as our livelihood, our health, and our might. Unworthy as we are, we pray that you conceive, bless and grace us that our lives may be fulfilled. From sin may we abstain, in God we remain, as we also beseech thee, servant of the most holy, to instruct us in the gospel, that we may reflect and believe. Our requests are before thee, our hearts repent, resolving earnestly not to sin again, to always follow God the Father, together with the Spirit and Jesus the Mediator. Amen. Please all sit.
Ilan lamang pong mga paalaala. Una, sa inyong pagbisita sa pambansang Dambana, mangyaring pakaingatan ng inyong mga personal na gamit. Hangad namin ang isang matiwasay at maayos na pagbisita sa National Shrine. Ikalawa, sa paligid ng ating simbahan ay may makikita kayong mga Pilgrim's Information Record Book. Kami po'y nakikiusap na pakisulat ng inyong pangalan at ilang mga hinihinging detalye. Ito po'y tulong sa documentation program at alaala ng inyong pagbisita sa National Shrine. Kung kayo po'y mga balikbayan o mga OFW o may kasamang mga foreigner, doon po kayo magsusulat sa International Pilgrims Record Book. Ito po'y tulong sa ating ginagawang aplikasyon ngayon sa pambansang Dambana. Patuloy po ang ating paghahanda para sa Kapaskuhan, ang oras ng Misa di Gallo, alas 4:30 ng madaling araw, at ang simbang gabi ay sa 5:00 ng hapon. Kayo ay lagi naming inaanyayahan, sana'y makapag-alay ng mga dried goods, bigas, dilata, noodles at iba pa na ating pwedeng ipamahagi sa mga kapatid natin sa Isla Verde at sa Tingloy para sa bagong taon. Ngayon din pong darating na Sabado ay 23 ng buwan, araw ng pagpapagaling ng Diyos sa pamamagitan ni Padre Pio, ang ating mga healing masses at healing liturgy na may pagpapahid ng langis, una ay sa alas 9 ng umaga at meron din sa alas 5 ng hapon. Kayo po at ang inyong mga may sakit ay inaanyayahan. Maraming salamat sa inyo. Inaasahan naming pananatilihin niyo ang kalinisan, katahimikan at diwa ng pananalangin sa loob at labas ng ating simbahan. Meron po tayong banal na oras mamayang alas 8 ng gabi. Kayo ring lahat ay inaanyayahang makiisa. Please all stand para po sa pagbabasbas ng religious articles. Mga kapatid, manalangin tayo sa Diyos sa mang makapangyarihan upang tayo'y maging kawangis ni Kristo sa taimtim na pagdalangin sa tulong ng mga larawan at mga dasalan. Inyo pong hahawakan ang inyong mga nais pabasbasan, isipin ang mga taong nais niyong ipanalangin para po sa mga nasa kanilang tahanan, ang panalangin ito'y para din sa inyo at sa inyong mga nais pabindisyonan. O Panginoong Diyos, ikaw ang bukal ng lahat ng pagpapala at biyaya. Ibuhos mo ang iyong bendisyon sa mga gamit na ito sa pananalangin, ang mga rosaryo, mga imahen, mga dasalan, mga healing rub at mga miracle oil na nagpapaalaala ng iyong kabutihan, kabanalan at pagmamahal sa amin, upang ang lahat na dumulog at magdasal gamit ang mga ito ay magtamo ng iyong awa at biyaya. Loobin mong tularan nila ang kabanalan at aral ng Panginoon at mga santo magpasawalang hanggan.
Amen. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Glory be to the Father, to the Son, to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. Our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen.
We thank all our servers and all of you who participated in this Holy Mass. Thank you very much and take care always. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace to love and serve the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Nagpupuri sa may kapag ang bukong kalooban dahil sa kadakilan ang ginawa niyang tanan sa kanyang kapangyarihan. Purihin, purihin natin ang Diyos. Purihin, purihin natin.